In this collab, we will walk through an example of applying MinDiff to mitigate underperforming subgroups in a classification model. MinDiff typically improves the performance of a given subgroup of data, sometimes referred to as a slice, by minimizing the score distribution between two groups. Let's get started. For this model, we will use the civil comments dataset, which consists of text comments from the internet and a label indicating if the comment is considered toxic. The dataset also includes identity attributes representing the identities that are mentioned in the comment. These are gender, sexuality, religion, race, and disability. We will examine the original model's performance with respect to the religious attribute and use MinDiff to mitigate any issues we may find. Let's first start by training a Keras model without MinDiff to understand how our base model performs. Now let's pull up fairness indicators and review the performance of our initial model by looking at the religious slice. Note that in a production environment, we recommend taking a thoughtful approach to determine which categories and metrics to evaluate. Given that we're concerned with incorrectly labeling a comment as toxic, we will select false positive rates and review this metric. We can see that the model does not perform well for certain subgroups. For others, the large confidence intervals indicates that there's not enough data and that we'd have to gather additional data before coming to any conclusions about remediation. For the subgroups with enough data, we could apply MinDiff to try to reduce the gap. MinDiff expects additional data corresponding to the majority and minority groups. Selecting the examples of these groups is one of the most important parts of MinDiff. Since we are concerned with the false positive rate, we will only look at the negative examples. The two subgroups with the highest false positive rate will be used as our minority group, and the lowest false positive rate will be used as our majority group. Once the data is prepared, we wrap the original model in a MinDiff model and include the additional MinDiff loss and weight. The MinDiff model can then be compiled and trained as with any typical Keras model. Now we can review the performance of the MinDiff model and look at the false negative rate for each group in religion. Note that although we did not increase the size of the dataset, the model confidence intervals and false positive rates improved. Note that with this example, all subgroups improved their false positive rate, but this may not always be the case. After implementing MinDiff, be sure to double check that the changes are suitable for the model overall and specific subgroups. Adjust the input parameters as needed. I hope you found this video useful. Please hit the thumbs up button if you did, and view additional resources in the description below. Thanks for watching.